Live and direct from Vandalia High School in Vandalia, Illinois, it's exciting Edwards County Lady Lions Volleyball. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Dave Rigg alongside Troy Rigg, and it's going to be our privilege here this afternoon to bring you the super-sectional match between the Edwards County Lady Lions and the Waterloo Gibault Catholic Hawks. I think that's what they call them, isn't it?
That is correct, sir.
And the winner of this match goes on to play next weekend in Normal, Illinois at Redbird Arena in the state finals. Troy, this is the third year in a row that the Lady Lions have reached the Elite Eight. That's what we are now, the Elite Eight. There are only eight teams in the whole state of Illinois left in Class 2A. Edwards County is one of them. And we win here this afternoon, and we become a member of the Final Four for the third year in a row. And certainly that's quite an accomplishment for Edwards County High School athletes. Right now you can see there on your screen, the Lady Lions are out there on the court practicing their shots at the net as Coach Casey Nelson is out there feeding the balls to the girls, setting it up at the net. And so we're glad to have you watching and listening to our broadcast here today on Edwards County SportsNet, the broadcast coming your way through the courtesy of the Edwards County Broadcast Boosters. And Troy's going to check some of the members right now.
David and Glenna Summers, Pam Mann, Nina Mann, and Terry Mavis, Robert and Damona Neese, Bob and Linda Caldwell, Marla Caldwell Alexander, cheering on cousins Nicole and Zoe from Anacortes, Washington.
I think that's right.
We'll go with that. Brad and Tammy Nail, Eddie and Joyce Miller, Kent and Sue Nail of Nail's Funeral Homes in Albion and Fairfield, Gospel Chapel, a non-denominational church in Bungap. Services begin every Sunday morning at 10. Janice Shaw of Janice's Beauty Shop in Albion. She offers a complete line of beauty shop services for women, and she also cuts hair for men. Call Janice for an appointment, 445-2436. Radio station WVYN 90.9 in Wayne City, The Vine, featuring the best Christian music in Southern Illinois. And they had an interview today with my brother.
Yeah, they did.
Do you need your carpets cleaned? Call Dan Aaron of Dan's Carpet Cleaning, 618-302-0972. Dan, Shirley, Michael, and Travis are cheering on the Lions. Sam and Sheila Smith, Ed and Mary Bailey, The Watering Can at 107 West Main Street. Stop in and see the flower and gift items that Nathan has available. Call 445-3924. Chris and Teresa Kelsey, Steve Thompson, your country financial agent in West Salem, and Doug Horton, your country financial agent in Albion.
Troy, as I look below us here, we're located, I think, because it's hard for me to tell directions for sure when we get into a town I've never been before, but I think we're on the east side of the gym, and right below us, the Edwards County cheering section of fans. And I have to wonder if there's anybody left in Edwards County this afternoon. Certainly, I would guess the streets of Albion are pretty quiet today because, boy, I tell you what, we have got a lot of people up here, Troy. I'd say our side of the gymnasium here is at least 70% populated.
Oh, yeah.
And that's amazing because you look across the way at the crowd that has come here from Waterloo. And by the way, Waterloo is just about the same distance from Vandalia as we are, maybe a little bit shorter distance.
Yeah.
But they've got a few fans over there, but not nearly the turnout of fan support that we have here on Edwards County side. And if I started right now naming all the names that I see, we wouldn't have time for the broadcast.
No, probably
so that's
not
a great tribute to the fan support of these Lady Lions in Edwards County for this team. And can we beat this Gibault club? That's the question that's on our minds. Well, the answer is yes, but it depends on what team shows up here for Edwards County. If the girls play like they played a couple of weeks ago on a Saturday afternoon at Mount Pulaski, we will lose. If the girls play the same kind of game that they played a few Saturdays ago in the afternoon in our invitational tournament in Albion, we will lose. But if we play the kind of game that we saw the other night at Flora in the sectional championship game, and for that matter, the regional semifinal and championship match, the Lady Lions will win this. So we're just going to have to wait and see how the Lady Lions play here today, because our four losses, we're, 33-4 now?
Correct, sir.
And the four losses that we suffered this year came on a Saturday afternoon.
Yep.
And let's be honest about it. It was not a very good effort by the Lady Lions in those four losses. the thing that's encouraging about those four losses, maybe it brought the girls down to earth and showed them you can't just show up on the court and expect to win.
Yep.
You've got to play good volleyball, and certainly they have done that since that time.
Yep.
We have not seen that kind of shoddy volleyball that we saw on that Saturday afternoon in Albion and that Saturday afternoon in Mount Pulaski. So if the Lady Lions play like they did the other night, we're going to be going to state.
Yep.
And if we do, Troy and I will be there. The only difference is the IHSA will not allow us to do video like we're doing here today. All we can do is audio. So we will revert to an audio broadcast. Now, if you want to watch the Lady Lions up there, the IHSA will be glad to let you do that for a fee.
Uh-huh.
They'll charge you to watch it on their website. But you can listen to it for free here on Edwards County Sportsnet. And that's another thing. The IHSA is going to charge Troy and I $100. Another $100 fee we're going to have to come up with to broadcast up there at Normal next weekend, next Friday and Saturday. Who are the eight teams that are still left in this tournament in Class 2A? Well, I'll tell you about that after Troy checks more of our broadcast boosters.
Cheryl Taylor and Mary Erickson of T.J. Marsh backing the Lady Lions. T.J. Marsh, over 30 years of serving and supporting the community. Edwards County Superintendent of Schools, David Cowger. Sadie Marks family, Kent, Jamie Lynn Clay, and Ellie Marks, David and Lisa Mathis, Doug and Linda Raper. Doug is your state farm insurance agent in Albion, Gene Kolak, owner of the Man Cave Gallery in Fairfield, Western Memorabilia, motivational posters, pictures, and Native American art. Gene carries many custom handmade and factory knives, Chad, Merle, Lindsay, and Seth McKenzie of McKenzie Farms, Dr. Chris Ballard and his wife Jerry, Kevin, Heidi, and T.J. Smurden, Keith, Kayla Avery, and Drew Roosevelt, family of senior band member and volleyball player Taylor Roosevelt. David and Amy Brewster of Brewster Enterprises Incorporated, supporting Kate Brewster. Russ, Seeley, Max, and Clive Gerlach, and Linda Sachs.
All of those folks that Troy mentioned, plus more of these that he'll be mentioning as the broadcast goes on, are paying only $1. That's all, $1. To help us cover our expenses here this afternoon in Vandalia. Now, I had a conversation with Stu Markman here just a few minutes ago before our broadcast time, and he said we're not charging enough. He said, Dave, you ought to charge at least $2 to help cover your expenses. And, well, that's a good idea. We're not going to do that now. We started out the volleyball season at $1 per broadcast, and we're going to stick to that. However, we are going to be doing the Edwards County boys basketball varsity games this year on Edwards County Sportsnet. All of them, all of the varsity games for the boys basketball team will be broadcast here on Edwards County Sportsnet. And that's an idea that Troy and I are going to have to kick around. Do we want to increase the fee to $2 a broadcast or keep it at $1? And we would appreciate your feedback. Stu says, I don't think anybody that you've got on the broadcast boosters now would be unwilling to pay $2 rather than $1 to help you boys cover your expenses. Because, Troy, we are. We're just barely covering our expenses during close games. And when we have to go to Vandalia, especially next week when we go to Normal, we'll not only have to pay that $100 broadcast license fee
right
to the IHSA, but we'll have the expense of a motel room for one night and the gasoline to drive up there to Normal. So we do appreciate the help that we get. I got an email from a lady here this morning saying they were going to send me a donation and wanted to know how to send it. Well, let me just tell you that real quickly here. If you'd like to help us with our expenses, my mailing address is 1302 County Road 345 East, Albion, Illinois, 62806. And we would appreciate any help that you could give us in helping us cover our expenses of bringing you exciting Lady Lions volleyball. Okay, who are the eight teams still in competition to end up next weekend in Normal for the state finals? Well, at Athens this afternoon, it's Deer Creek Mackinac against Williamsville. At Beecher, it's Westmont against Watseka. At Champaign, it's St. Joe Ogden against Marissa Forsyth. At Elmhurst, it's Lake Forest Woodlands Academy against Elmhurst Immaculate Conception Catholic. Am I looking at the right page here, Troy? No, I'm looking at the wrong page. I'm sorry. Those are scores. Wipe all that out, folks. I'm so excited about this game, folks, I can't get my paper straight here. Okay, let's try it again.
Reboot.
Yeah. The teams that are still in the contention. at Chicago this afternoon, or actually at 5 o'clock this evening, Watseka will tangle with the defending state champion, the team that beat us last year in the championship game, Elmhurst Immaculate Conception Catholic. At Granville Putnam County this afternoon, and that's another 6 o'clock game. In fact, we're the only one playing an afternoon game. They're all playing night games elsewhere.
Right.
At Putnam County, Granville, it's Fieldcrest Minunk against Dakota. Fieldcrest is a team we beat last year up there at Normal.
At
Moroa Forsyth, it's Deer Creek Mackinac against Moroa Forsyth. And here at Vandalia, it's Edwards County against Waterloo Gibault Catholic. So all of the four teams that made it to the state finals last year are still in contention. Elmhurst Immaculate Conception Catholic, Fieldcrest, Deer Creek Mackinac, and of course Edwards County. So it's quite possible that the same four teams that were there last year competing for the Class 2A state championship will be back there next weekend, next Friday and Saturday. And by the way, let me look at the schedule here so I can kind of give you an idea of what's coming up. I'm going to use that word win. When Edwards County wins this Super Sectional, their opponent next Friday afternoon at 12 noon will be the winner of the Moroa Forsyth Super Sectional. And that would be either Deer Creek Mackinac or Moroa Forsyth. And then at 1:30, it's the winner of the Granville Putnam County Super Sectional against the winner of the Christ the King Super Sectional at 1:30. And of course, when the Lady Lions win that match on next Friday afternoon at 12 noon, they would play for the state championship a week from today at 1:55 against, we don't know. But anyhow, that's the lineup. We win this game, we play at 12 noon next Friday, and then hopefully for the state championship next Saturday at about 1:55. Troy, check some more broadcast boosters.
Jeff Gillard of Gillard True Value Hardware in Albion and Grayville. Connie and Ray Root, grandparents of Maddie Gillard. Myrna Mason, Rainey and Jared Hallam of Mitchell Insurance Agency in Albion. Steve and Beverly Ward, Don and Marilyn Brewster, Jason Holfaker, Linda Oxby, former Edwards County Girls Volleyball coach, Emma Campbell-Smith, Betty and Kenny Smith, Zoe Markman's great-grandparents, and Eddie and Lila Fuchs.
Okay, it looks like they're lining the girls up along the sidelines here, getting ready for the playing of the national anthem. I don't know whether we'll be able to pick it up with our headset mics here from the PA system. Quite possible. We've got some speakers right here in front of us, so we might be able to pick it up. Lady Lions will be starting the match on the court to our right, and Waterloo Gibault Catholic on the court to the left of the net. You can hear all that hand clapping. That's for the Edwards County girls. Well, they're not as big in numbers as we are, but they raised a pretty good ruckus over there, Troy. That guy did a pretty good job, Troy. He's almost as good as I am.
I have no comment.
The people at my church at Gospel Chapel in Bone Gap would have a comment on that.
Yeah, probably.
All right, let's get the starting lineup. Gibault Catholic Hawks will be the visiting squad here. Really, that only matters as far as the scoreboard is concerned. Outside hitter is number 14, Kelly Dooley. She is a 5'8 freshman. Number five, another outside here is Lauren Schmidt. She's a 5'9 sophomore. You're going to see they're a very young team. Carolyn Pappenberg is their middle hitter. She's 5'9. She's a freshman. Number nine, Lauren Schmidt. I got her down as number five. 5'9 sophomore. Number 15, that's Bailey Lehman. She's a 5'8 freshman. Their setter is number 12, Ashley Groman, a 5'10 sophomore. She's their setter. Their libero is Madeline O'Neill, 5'3 sophomore. So as I look down this roster, Troy, they don't have a senior on this roster anywhere.
They do not. One junior.
Yeah. So a very young squad, but a very good squad. But you know, folks, this is a private school, which means they don't have to stay within their boundary, any boundary lines to get players. All right, now we're going to get the starting lineup for the Edwards County Lady Lions. Outside hitter number 31, Sadie Marks. She is a 5'4 junior. Zoe Markman is our setter, one of our setters. She stands 5'2". She's a sophomore. So she'll be back next year. Nicole Alcorn, a 5'10 senior, listed as a middle blocker. Bailey James, at number 30, she's worn for a long time. She's the 6-foot senior outside hitter. Sadie Merbarger, another senior, standing 5'5", is a setter. Number 19, Caitlin Schmidtler, a 5'10 senior, one of our middle blockers. Caitlin can be a wall there at the net. Casey Nelson, of course, is our head coach with Terry Compton and Erica Bishop, her assistants. So, Troy, we're just about ready to start this match to decide who's going to go to Normal next weekend for the state finals. This is the Super Sectional here in Vandalia, Edwards County against Waterloo Gibault Catholic. Quickly, Troy, what do we know about this team?
We know that they had kind of the same fate, Dave, up at the Mount Pulaski Invitational. They started out red hot in the morning. In fact, pulled what some would say were a couple of upsets. But then in the afternoon, they hit a wall, suffered some losses, and ended up having to settle for playing for fifth and sixth place against Shelbyville.
Okay.
We know they don't have a whole lot of experience, but their two outside hitters, Goldschmidt and Dooley, are a couple of very good young players, Dave. And, of course, you don't get to the Super Sectional on a fluke.
No, no, no. When you get this far, you're a good volleyball team.
Absolutely.
All right, both teams are now huddled up. Edwards County on the right side there on your picture. And the Gibault Hawks on the left side, standing there at the free throw line on the basketball court. And, again, a big turnout of Edwards County fans here. They made the drive over here to Vandalia. And now we're ready to root the Lions on to another appearance in the state finals at Normal next weekend. But first, we got to get past this team from Waterloo, a private school out of Waterloo called Gibault Catholic. And Sadie Marks will have the first serve of the match for Edwards County. Sadie's waiting for the whistle. And the officials are still at the net, making sure everybody that's out there should be out there. And we do have line judges again here today, which is required by the IHSA. And so that helps a lot as far as making sure you get the right call on close plays. All right, there's the whistle, and here we go, folks. There's the serve. It's a good one to the middle. There's the dig. Bumped up towards the middle to the left side, pushed back to us, and it is out. So Edwards County jumps up to a 1-0 lead as one of their outside hitters, number 9, Lauren Goldschmidt, knocked it out of bounds as she tried to shoot it across court. Sadie Marks will serve it again. Sadie pushes it down the right side this time. There's their set to the middle, a shot partially blocked, and it falls to the floor. Off the block, there was a little indecision there, it appears, between Alcorn, Markman, and James as to who was going to try to dig it out. Neither of the three did it, and that ties the score at one. And back to serve is Bailey Lehman. She's a freshman. Here it comes. There's the dig back there by Marks. Zoe sets it from the right side to the left. Kaylee shoots it, blocked back to us, but Caitlin digs it out. Shot by Kaylee James is too long. Over the end line it goes. So Gibault Catholic takes a 2-1 lead here in set number one. Once again, Bailey Lehman. She stands 5'8". We'll have the serve for the Hawks. There it goes, back to the back row, dig by Schmittler. Zoe sets it up to the left. Kaylee shoots it and knocks it out again. Well, Kaylee's off to a slow start here, Troy. And Gibault takes a 3-1 lead here in set one. Remember, you got to win two sets. 25 is the winning score. There's the serve. Dig back there by Schmittler. Set up by Zoe. Here's Alcorn with a shot. That's blocked at the net. They dig it out, push it back to us. And a well-placed push over on the court. And Sadie Merbarger could not get to it. So Gibault Catholic jumps out to a 4-1 lead here now. Lehman again gets the serve. Comes forward, swats it down the middle. There's the dig by Schmittler. At the net, knocked back down, and it is in. So now it's 5-1, Gibault. Not a good start for Edwards County. Let's see what happens here on this serve now. There it goes down the middle. Schmittler digs it out. Zoe just pushes it over. And they push it to their left side. There's a shot across court, and that's another kill. Caitlin Schmittler could not get to it on the far side of the court. And Gibault's up 6-1.
Kelly Dooley, the freshman.
All right. Here comes the serve now. Back row. That's going to be over the end line. That'll be a service error against Gibault. And that makes the score Gibault 6, Edwards County 2. And Zoe Markman will go back to serve it for Edwards County. Zoe steps forward, shoots it to the middle of the court. There's the dig at the net. They set it to the left. A shot actually just tipped over, and it is out. That was close. Kaylee decided to let it go, and it's a good thing she did, Troy. I don't think she could have played that one.
No.
And it makes it 6-3. Markman with a serve again. Good serve down the right side. There's their dig. Push it back to the left. Tip over to us. Nice save by Kaylee, but it goes into the crowd. Well, I tell you what, Gibault is looking, Troy, before they hit the ball to see where open spots are, and that's where they're setting it.
That's what they're doing.
Gibault 7, Edwards County 3. Here comes their serve. Jump serve. Dig back there by Schmittler. Alcorn saves it. Does she get it over? Nope, that's going to be out. Gibault 8, Edwards County 3. Once again, serving will be Kelly Dooley, a 5'8 freshman. Kelly dribbling the volleyball now, steps forward with her jump serve. Back row dig by Schmittler. Set up by Merbarger. Alcorn pushes it over to them. And they dig that out, set it to their middle, and the shot is going to be out. And Edwards County will get that point. So that makes it now Gibault Catholic 8, Edwards County 4. And Nicole Alcorn will go back to serve it for Edwards County. As usual, Nicole likes to serve from the left side of the end line. She gets the whistle. And here comes her jump serve. Right down the middle it goes. There's the dig. Pushed to the left side. Shot partially blocked. Dug out by Markman. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Kaylee. They dig it out. Bump it over to the left side again. A shot blocked down by Schmittler, but right back to us. And Schmittler tips it down, but they keep it alive. Back to their left side. Another tip over. Saved by Markman. Bumped over by Schmittler. Good defense by Edwards County. Pushed to the left side again. A shot is a good kill. Well placed shot by Lauren Goldschmidt, the 5'9 sophomore. And now it's Gibault Catholic 9, Edwards County 4. And their libero, Madeline O'Neill, a 5'3 sophomore, will serve it. And down the middle she sends it. Dug by James, set by Zoe. Merbarger spanks it. Schmittler did, and she got in the net. Schmittler in the net. And that now makes it Gibault 10. 10 for Gibault and 4 for Edwards County. Madeline O'Neill will serve it for the Hawks out of Waterloo, Illinois, over by the St. Louis area. There's the dig by Alcorn, pushed up by James. Shot by Caitlin, goes into the net. 11-4, and Casey Nelson wants timeout. Troy?
Victor and Farrell Oxby, Linda Oxby's parents, Phil and Nancy Watkins in Grants Pass, Oregon, Megan's grandparents, Ronald and Marilyn Mann, Don and Deanna James, Kaylee James' grandparents, Larry and Linda Schmittler, grandparents of Caitlin Schmittler, Larry Schmittler Service, Oilfield Engine Repair in Grayville, Stu, Shadina, Zed, and Zimmy Markman, Zoe's family, Tom and Kay Moore, Taylor Roosevelt's grandparents, Roger, Rita, and Kenzie James, Kaylee James' family, Lonnie, Valerie, and Hallie Merbarger, and Anna, and Sadie's family, Daryl and Judy Knight, Nicole Alcorn's grandparents, Gene and Jackie Copeland, Georgia Shirley Tribe, and Glenn and Marilyn Clodfelder, Kaylee James' grandparents.
Well, Troy, in this early going here, I have to say we're seeing the same kind of volleyball we've seen on two other Saturday afternoons, and that didn't turn out good.
That's true. And the other thing we're seeing, these may be a bunch of freshmen and sophomores over on this end of the court, but don't underestimate them.
That's right. All right. They still have the serve. Madeline O'Neill, their libero. It's now 11-4. Gibault Catholic with the lead. There's the whistle, and here comes the serve. Down the middle, dig by Alcorn, set up by Zoe, shot by Kaylee, blocked back to us, Alcorn digs it out, Zoe sets it, Caitlin shoots it in the net. 12-4, Gibault. All right, here comes their serve. Back row dig there by James, set up by Zoe. Tip into the net by Mobarger. It's a lift they call against us. 13-4. All right, another serve by O'Neill for the Hawks of Gibault. There it goes, down the middle, dig by Alcorn. Zoe tries to save it, and she does, pushed over by Mobarger. They dig it out, set it to the middle, shot. It's going to be in. 14-4. Not looking good, folks, but don't give up yet. I know we can beat this team, Troy. We're just not playing good volleyball.
You got to break their momentum, too.
Yeah. All right, O'Neill with another serve. There it goes to the back row, dig by James. Set up by Zoe. Kaylee just tips it over. We got to quit that tipping, Troy, and shoot the ball. There's a shot down the left side, and that is out. So we'll get a point out of that. Gibault 14, Edwards County 5, and Kaylee James will go back to serve it. All right, here comes the serve. It's a good one to the middle of the court. There's their dig. Push to the left, shot into the net. Well, we'll take that. 14-6. Kaylee will go back to serve it again. Kaylee wants to be sure this is not her last high school volleyball game. There's the serve down the middle. There's their dig. At the net, they bump it up. Left side, shot. Is a kill. Alcorn dove but couldn't get under it. That was a well-placed kill, Troy.
Ashley Grohman on the shot.
And that makes it now 15-6. And let's see. I can't see the girl's number. Number 12. Okay, that'd be Ashley Grohman. She's a sophomore. All right, here she comes forward. There's the serve. There's the dig by James. Merbarger sets it up. Schmettler shoots it, and they dig that out. They push it to the middle. Tipped over to us, dug out by James, and it's knocked down for a point for Waterloo by Pappenberger.
But it's ours. She was
in the net,
over
the net.
Over.
Okay, well, we'll take that. That makes it 16-6. Is that right? I think we got seven.
I think we should have seven.
I think so too. All right, Merbarger. We got a substitute. Here's Megan Watkins checking in for Zoe Markman. That means Sadie Merbarger will be serving. It is 14-7. I'm sorry. There's a serve by Merbarger. Good serve. Pushed to the middle. Shot down the back row. Nice dig by Alcorn. Bumped up there. Pushed over by Kaylee. Now on the back row, they dig it out. Push it to their left. Here comes another shot. Kaylee digs it out, but can we save it? Sadie does save it. And bumped back over by Schmittler. Good play by Edwards County. Here's another push over, and once again, they find an open spot. These girls, Troy, have got to be working before the ball ever gets
to
them.
Dave, they're not just finding the open spot. They're looking
for the
open spot and getting it.
16-7. Gibault Catholic with the lead in set one. Here's their serve. Dig by Alcorn. Bumped up by Merbarger. Shot by Watkins. They dig that out. Push it to the right side. A shot is going to be another point. Man, oh, man, they're making short work of us. 17-7. This should not be so, folks. Once again, Gibault has the serve. And here it comes. And it's out. That's the service error. It goes over the end line. Edwards County will get that point. 17-8. Can we come back and win this set? Yes, but we got to play better than we've been playing. All right. Caitlin Schmettler will have the serve. There it goes. In the middle, there's the dig at the net. Set to the left. Shot. Partially blocked. Kaylee digs it out. Merbarger sets it. Mark shoots it, but they dig that out. Push it to the middle. A shot. Dug out by Merbarger. Set up by Watkins. Alcorn shoots it. They dig it out again. Push it over to us. And a whistle. Somebody's in the net.
No, they were up over the top of it again.
Okay. Now that makes it 17-9. Lions trying to make a comeback here in set one. Schmittler again with the serve for Edwards County. There it goes down the middle. There's their dig from the middle of the court. Right side push to the left side. A shot to the back row. Nice dig by Schmittler. Bumped up by Merbarger. Watkins tips it over, but they dig that out. Back to the left side again. They tip it over to us. Nice save by Merbarger. At the net, they shoot it down. Is that number 14 again?
That was Dooley again.
Yeah, that Kelly Dooley. She's tough. 18-9 the score. Carolyn Pappenberger, a 5'9 freshman, will serve it. There it goes to the back row, dug by Schmittler, set up by Merbarger. Kaylee from the middle of the court shoots it, and they push it to the middle, bump it back to us. Kaylee digs that out. Merbarger sets it, and Mark shoots it, blocked, but Kaylee dug it out. Merbarger sets it. Watkins shoots it, and a kill for Megan Watkins. Megan Watkins gets that kill for Edwards County, and that makes it Edwards County down by 8 points, 18-10. And Sadie Marks will go back to serve it. For the Lady Lions, we've got Watkins, Alcorn, and James on the front row. There's the serve. It's a good one. At the net. There's the shot back there. Dug by Marks. Pushed over by Schmittler. Marks shoots it back over. They keep it alive on their side. Left side shot off of the block. It's going to be over the end line, but we touched it. Another point for Gibault Catholic. And they send a substitute in. Bailey Lehman comes in to serve now. It's 19-10 here in set number one. Gibault Catholic with a lead. Here comes the serve. Back row dig by Marks. Watkins sets it up. Caitlin, they tried to block it at the net, and it fell off the block to the floor. So Caitlin gets that point. 19-11. Schmittler will go back to serve it. Now here's Zoe coming back in, and she's going to serve it instead as Watkins goes to the bench. Come on, Zoe. Let's get a big string of successful serves here now. Markman serve to the middle. There's the dig. At the net, they set it to the left. A shot blocked back over, but they keep it alive. They push it back to their left side. A shot dug out by James. Set up by Markman. Shot by Alcorn is good. Yeah! Nicole Alcorn, the senior outside hitter, hammers that one down. Gibault 19, Edwards County 12. Markman again will have the serve. Come on, girls. There's Markman's serve. It's a good one to the middle. There's the dig towards the net. And a shot down the middle. It's too long. It's over the end line. That'll be another point for Edwards County. 19-13. Lions beginning to close the gap here in set one.
Gibault wants a touch, but they're not going to get it.
No, we didn't touch that at all.
No.
Here's Markman's serve. Another one to the middle of the court. They bump it up on the second hit. Bump it back to us. Let it go. It's over the end line. Gibault 19, Edwards County 14. Come on, Zoe. Edwards County fans love it. And now Gibault wants timeout. Troy?
Volleyball MC Todd Bailey of PCB Detail Repair and Tires on the Square in Albion. When you need tires, check with Todd. Bill and Susan Markman, grandparents of Zoe Markman, Kerry Wayne, JT, and Callie Doss, cheering on Nicole Alcorn from Spring, Texas. Kathy and Jim Markman of CJ's Auto Sales and Service and CJ's Rental Homes. Former Midwest kid Gary Holtman, now in Grants Pass, Oregon. Earl and Judy Loudermill. Tim and Alicia Yates. Debbie Smith, the new Edwards County Treasurer. Kai Coleman, Kaylee James' cousin. David and Glenna Summers. Pam Mann, Nina Mann, and Terry Mavis. Robert and Damona Neese. Bob and Linda Caldwell. Marla Caldwell Alexander, cheering on cousins Nicole and Zoe from Anacortes, Washington. Brad and Tammy Nail, and Eddie and Joyce Miller. And Dave, we need to take these Hawks out of their momentum and rhythm.
Yeah, they really had things going their way there for quite a while.
Yep.
Lions beginning to cut into that deficit, which now amounts to 5 points,
right.
19-14. Zoe Markman still has the serve.
Keep it up, Zoe.
Come on, Zoe. Zoe looks to the bench for directions from Casey Nelson where she wants it served. There it goes to the middle and back row. Push to the left side again. Tip over to us. Nice save by Zoe. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Kaylee. Is off the top of the net. And do we get that point? I think so. They blocked it, didn't they, Troy?
They blocked it.
They blocked it out of bounds. That makes it 19-15. All right, Markman with the serve again. Come on, girls. There it goes. middle of the back row dig. Bump towards the back row again. Shot back there, dug out by Marks. Zoe, no, actually Schmittler sets it up, and Kaylee shoots it and scores! Kaylee James from the left side hammers it down this near sideline, and that makes it 19-16. That ought to shake up the Gibault Catholic Hawks. All right, here's Markman's serve. Good serve down the right side this time. They push it over the net, and once again we're sleeping, Troy.
Yep, they weren't ready for it. Well, they thought, Dave, that they were getting ready for a big setup there for Goldschmidt or something, and they just tipped it back over.
Gibault 20, Edwards County 16. Serving now is Kelly Dooley. Jump serve, dug out by Merbarger, set up by Schmittler, pushed back over there by Alcorn. It's on their side now. Left side, here's a shot, partially blocked, out of bounds. It goes off of our block. 21-16, set one. Come on, girls.
Goldschmidt strikes again.
Yeah, she does. All right, Dooley again with a serve. Here she comes with her jump serve. Dig back there by Merbarger. Zoe sets it up. Alcorn tips it. What are we doing with all this tipping stuff, boy? Left side shot goes into the net. And that'll be a point for us. 21-17. That's what we got into on those Saturday afternoons when we lost instead of shooting it. 21-17. Alcorn will serve it. Here she comes. Good serve. Middle of the court dig. Ball pushes to the left side again. Shot hit the top of the net. Saved by Zoe. Bumped up by Schmittler. Shot by Kaylee, but they dig it out. Push it again to the left side. A shot is
off the arm of Nicole.
If Nicole had only stayed away from it, we'd have got that point, but we didn't. So now it's Gibault 22, Edwards County 17. And their libero, Madeline O'Neill, goes back to serve it. Here it comes. Back row dig by James. Zoe sets it up. Kaylee shoots it, blocked back over, but out of bounds. So Kaylee gets the kill. 22-18. Come on, Kaylee. Keep it going. All right, Kaylee looks to the bench and gets the sign. Here comes the serve. It's a good one to the middle. There's the dig. Right side, they push it to the left again. There's the shot, partially blocked, dug out by Alcorn. Set up by Markman. Marks shoots it over and gets the point. She placed that shot well. Just a little bit out of the reach of the backline libero, O'Neill. So now it's 22-19. Lions closing in. Kaylee James again with the serve. There it goes, down the middle. There's their dig. And they bump it, and now they push it back. They're blocked down by Caitlin, but they keep it alive. Left side shot. It's touched again. We're trying to block it at the net, Troy, and it's going off our blocks out of bounds. 23-19. Gibault with the lead and the serve. Ashley Groman will serve it. This is the super sectional match here in Vandalia. There's the serve. Back row dig by Alcorn. Kaylee bumps it up towards the net. Pushed over by Marks to save it. Now they push it to their left side. Here's Dooley again. And off of Alcorn's dig, we're not going to be able to save it. Now we're at set point.
Bottom line is, Dave, at some point in time during this game, they're going to have to figure out how to neutralize Goldschmidt.
Well, and we're going to have to figure out how to get some shots like we got the other night.
That's true, too.
24-19. They're within 1 point of winning the first set. Here it comes. Into the net, but it goes over. Schmittler digs it out. Alcorn, or check that. Zoe sets it, and Marks knocks it over to him. Here's another shot from the left side, and that's it. 25-19. 25-19. Gibault wins set number one. Troy?
Kenton C. Nail and Nail's Funeral Homes in Albion and Fairfield. Gospel Chapel, a non-denominational church in Bone Gap. Services begin every Sunday morning at 10. Janice Shaw of Janice's Beauty Shop in Albion. She offers a complete line of beauty shop services for women, and she also cuts hair for men. Call Janice for an appointment, 445-2436. Radio station WBYN 90.9 in Wayne City, The Vine, featuring the best Christian music in Southern Illinois. Do you need your carpets cleaned? Call Dan Aaron of Dan's Carpet Cleaning, 618-302-0972. Dan, Shirley, Michael, and Travis are cheering on the Lions. Sam and Sheila Smith, Ed and Mary Bailey, The Watering Can at 107 West Main Street. Stop in and see the flowers and gift items Nathan has available. Call 445-3924. Chris and Teresa Kelsey, Steve Thompson, your country financial agent in West Salem, and Doug Horton, your country financial agent in Albion.
Have we ever lost the first set and went on to run, win the match? The answer is yes. Third game of the season against St. Anthony. We lost the first set and came back to win the next two. In the regular season match with Newton, we lost the first set, came back to win the next two. And in the match with Hamilton County in the Invitational Tournament, we lost the first set but came back to win the next two. And then, of course, things didn't go so well in that match with Robinson. Yes, it did. We came back in that.
We beat Robinson.
Yeah, that's right. We lost the first set against Robinson.
Right.
Came back to win that set. So, this is not the first time the Lions have lost the first set and didn't give up. But again, Troy, we're going to have a different strategy and play differently in set number two or we're done.
Yep. I mean, you hate to be that blunt, but yeah, that's it.
That's it. That's it. And right now, Casey Nelson is down there along with her assistants, Erica Bishop and Terry Compton, trying to get things ironed out for the Lady Lions because it's win or go home at right. this stage of the game. There's no, it's not a round robin tournament.
Nope.
And so if the Lions want to go to normal next weekend, they got to win this set and then win a third set. But again, they've done that before, so they could still do it, folks. Don't give up on them yet. So let's see how the Lions play here in set number two. Same lineup for Edwards County. Marks, Markman, James, Alcorn, Schmittler, and Merbarger. And the head coach for the Waterloo Gibault Catholic Hawks is still talking to her girls off here to our right. And now they break their huddle. And I would assume they'll have the first serve since we had the first one in set one. All right, Lady Lions there in their huddle at the free throw circle on the left side of the court. Break that. And the Hawks will have the first serve. Or so it seems. Yeah, I think they're their libero checks into the lineup
right.
now. So I don't know. No indication yet who's going to be serving here. Lions across the front line are going to have Markman, Merbarger, and Alcorn with Marks, James, and Schmittler on the back line. And Gibault Catholic will have the first serve. And there's the whistle. And here comes the serve. From the middle to dig by James. Set up by Merbarger. Tip over by Zoe. And they bump it up on the second hit. Shot back there. Dug out by Schmittler. It's above the net. Shot back there. And that's in. Caitlin couldn't get to it. And so another kill for the Gibault Catholic girls. And it's 1-0, Gibault.
And that's Goldschmidt at it again.
All right. They have another serve coming. And there it goes. Back row dig by Schmittler. Merbarger sets it up at the net. Tip over by Zoe. There we go to tipping again, Troy. They set it to the left. A shot. Dug out by James. Set up by Merbarger. Mark shoots it. Blocked back to us. And that's going to be another point. I've been told the reason we do the tipping is when we know they're going to be setting up blocks. Well.
And they've been effective at setting up blocks.
Yeah. All right, another serve. 2-0. Dig back there by Schmittler. Saved by him. Oh, that goes off Sadie's arm, and that's going to be another point for Gibault. 3-0. Back to serve, number 15, Bailey Lehman. Bailey looks for the whistle, gets the whistle. We're in set two. There it goes. Oh, dig, there goes that out of bounds, off the hands of Caitlin Schmittler. Well placed serve, Troy.
Yep.
Right between our front and back lines, and Caitlin couldn't get to it. 4-0. All right, here comes the serve. Back row dig by Schmittler. Set up there by Markman, pushed over by James. Now it goes back to the front of the net, and they hammer it into the net. Knocked into the net there by number 9, Lauren Goldschmidt. And so we finally get a point. It's Gibault Catholic 4, Edwards County 1. And Sadie Marks will go back to serve it. Sadie dribbles the ball now from the right side of the end line, knocks it down the court, and they hit it right into the net. That'll be an ace for Sadie. And that makes it now Gibault 4, Edwards County 2. Marks will be back next year. She's a junior. There's the serve to the back row, and that's an ace. They let that one drop. That was well within the line, so I don't know why they let that one whistle by. So it's Gibault 4, Edwards County 3. And once again, Sadie Marks will serve it.
Let's get some momentum going.
Amen. Amen. There goes the serve. Back row, there's their dig. At the middle of the net, they set it to the left. Here comes their shot, and it is in. Right down the left side of the court. Knocked in there. Was that Dooley again, Troy?
That was Goldschmidt.
Goldschmidt for the point. So it's 5-3, Gibault, and they'll have the serve now with Dooley serving. She runs forward with her jump serve. There's the dig by Merbarger. Set up by Zoe. Shot by Alcorn is a kill. That one will not be saved. Nice kill by Nicole Alcorn. That's what we got to start doing, Troy.
That's it.
All right. Gibault 5, Edwards County 4. Markman looks to the bench. Casey tells her where she wants it served. There it goes. Middle of the court dig. At the middle of the net, they set it to the left. Here's the shot, partially blocked, dug out by Alcorn, set up by Zoe. Kaylee shoots it to their back row. They dug it out. Push it again to their left side. There's the shot off the block. Can we save it? Marks cannot get it back over on the third hit. Oh, but Kaylee does. Okay. Push back to us. Zoe, Schmittler, Kaylee, a tip. What are we doing with this tip stuff, Troy? Bump right back to us. Marks, Schmittler, Kaylee tips again.
But that wasn't a good set, Dave.
All right, here's the push. The dig by Marks, set by Zoe. Alcorn shoots it for the kill.
That's a good set.
Yeah.
If you want to get those shots for Kaylee over in the corner, the sets have to be better.
Okay. That ties the score at 5, and Zoe Markman will serve it. You may be right, Troy. Maybe the sets haven't been good for Kaylee to kill it. All right, there's the serve. There's their dig. Middle of the court hammer and a whistle. Somebody got in the net.
We did.
Oh, man. You cannot afford to make these errors of in the net or service errors and win.
Not against this team.
6-5. O'Neill there, libero, will serve it. There's the serve. Into the net. Well, we'll take that. Let them do it all day. That ties the score again at 6. Alcorn will serve it. Nicole gets the whistle. And from the left side of the end line, shoots it down over the end line. Gibault 7, Edwards County 6. And let's see who's going to have the serve for them. It's number 12, Ashley Grohman. Grohman is a sophomore. As Troy said earlier, there's not a senior on this squad. There's the serve right into the net again. Keep doing that,
yeah.
Hawks. Tied at 7. Kaylee James to serve it. Kaylee gets the whistle. Here comes her serve. To the back row, there's their dig. They bump it back to the back row again. A shot blocked down by Schmittler. That's more like Lady Lions volleyball.
That's it.
Schmittler with a hammer from the middle. Caitlin the wall. Edwards County takes the lead for the first time this afternoon, Troy, 8-7. Kaylee with the serve. There it goes. Good serve to the middle. There's their dig. They bump it up on the second hit. Pushed back to us. Dig by Marks. And at the net, dug out by Markman, set over by Merbarger. It's on their side now. Shot knocked down by Schmittler, and that's going to be a point. Caitlin Schmittler knocks that one down. Edwards County 9, Gibault Catholic 7, and now they want to talk about it. Timeout, Troy.
Cheryl Taylor and Mary Erickson and T.J. Marsh backing the Lady Lions. T.J. Marsh, over 30 years of serving and supporting the community. Edwards County Superintendent of Schools, David Cowger. Sadie Marks family, Kent, Jamie Lee Clay, and Ellie Marks. David and Lisa Mathis. Doug and Linda Rayburn. Doug is your State Farm Insurance agent in Albion. Gene Kolak, owner of the Man Cave Gallery in Fairfield. Western memorabilia, motivational posters, pictures, and Native American art. Gene carries many custom handmade and factory knives. Chad, Marilee Lindsay, and Seth McKenzie of McKenzie Farms. Dr. Chris Ballard and his wife Jerry. Kevin, Heidi, and T.J. Smurden. Keith, Kayla Avery, and Drew Roosevelt, family of senior band member and volleyball player Taylor Roosevelt, and David and Amy Brewster of Brewster Enterprises Incorporated, supporting Kate Brewster.
Big crowd of Edwards County fans up here tonight, or this afternoon, to back the Lady Lions. They do not want to make that long two-hour drive home disappointed.
No.
Kaylee James will serve it. Edwards County leading 9-7 here in set number 2. There's the serve by Kaylee. It's a good one to the middle of the court. They bump it towards the net. Now to the middle. Shot blocked by Caitlin, and that's going to be called for a lift. So that makes it Edwards County 9 and Gibault Catholic 8. And back to serve for them is number 5. Well, I've got 5 as Lauren Goldschmidt, but they've got a number 9 out there somewhere. And that serves a good one. Dig by James. Set by Merbarger. Shot by Caitlin. Blocked back to us. James digs it out. Merbarger. And Marks tips it over to them. Now it's on their right side. Back to the left. Here comes a shot. Dug out by Alcorn. Set up by Zoe. Caitlin tips. Oh, and that's a good tip over. That's one time the tip worked.
That one worked.
All right, Edwards County 10, Gibault Catholic 8. And now here's Zoe going to the bench as Megan Watkins checks in. That's because it's time for Sadie Merbarger to serve. This is a traditional move that Coach Nelson makes when Merbarger's going to serve. There's the serve. It's a good one from the back row of the dig. Push to the left side. Tip over to us. Dug out by Merbarger. Set up by Watkins. Caitlin tips it in the net. Edwards County 10, Gibault Catholic 9. Now they send a substitute in. Number 9 checks back in. I don't know who she is, Troy. We don't have a number 9 on our score sheet.
Nope.
And now what are we going to get here? We're going to get another timeout? It looks like it. I don't know who called timeout, but somebody did. It's Edwards County 10, Gibault Catholic 9. Troy?
Didn't see that one at all.
I didn't either.
Russ Seeley, Max, and Clive Gerlach. Linda Sachs. Jeff Gillard of Gillard True Value Hardware in Albion and Grayville. Connie and Ray Root, grandparents of Maddie Gillard. Myrna Mason. Randy and Jared Halliman, Mitchell Insurance Agency in Albion. Steve and Beverly Ward. Don and Marilyn Brewster. Jason Holfaker. Linda Oxby, former Edwards County girls volleyball coach. Emma Campbell-Smith. Betty and Kenny Smith, Zoe Martin's great-grandparents. Eddie and Lila Fuchs. Victor and Farrell and Oxby, Linda Oxby's parents. Phil and Nancy Watkins in Grants Pass, Oregon. Megan's grandparents. Ronald and Marilyn Mann. And Don and Deanna James, Kaylee James' grandparents. Oh, and I think maybe part of the reason they took this man took a timeout is some girl is getting something wrapped down there.
Oh, okay. Yes, one of their players getting her just below her knee being wrapped up there. Looks like maybe a calf injury. Is that number 5, Lauren Goldschmidt?
Yeah. Yep.
She's back out there now. All right, they still have the serve, trailing by a point. Edwards County 10, Gibault Catholic 9. And we're in set number 2. Edwards County lost the first set, 25-19. Here comes the serve. Right into the net. Yeah, keep it up. Keep it up, Hawks. Edwards County now leading 11-9. And it's Caitlin Schmetley with the serve. Caitlin gets the whistle, shoots it down the middle, and there's their dig at the net. They bump it towards the middle, and back to us it comes. Let it go! There it is over the end line. Edwards County 12, Gibault 9. Set number 2. Lions right now have Alcorn, Watkins, and Marks on the front line. James, Merbarger, and Schmittler on the back line. Caitlin serving. Good serve to the middle of the court. There's their dig towards the net. Set up to the left. A shot is going to be in. Edwards County decided to let it go, hoping it would be out, but it fell inside the boundary line. So that makes it 12-10 now. And number 15, Bailey Lehman, a freshman, a 5'8 freshman, goes back to serve. There it goes. There's the dig by Kaylee. Set up by Merbarger. Alcorn shoots it out of bounds. 12-11. Set 2. Edwards County still leading, but only by 1 point. Gibault with the serve again. Here it comes. There's the dig back there by Marks. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Alcorn is a good kill. Nicole with a kill from the left side. Nicole the Nailer.
You may have to pass that along to her.
Yeah. 13-11. Edwards County by 2 now. And I think, yeah, Sadie Marks is going to have the serve for Edwards County. It's now James, Alcorn, and Watkins on the front line. There's the serve. There's their dig. In the middle of the net, they set it again to the left. Tip over to us. And a whistle. We got somebody in the net. It's against them.
No, it's against us.
Oh, no. 13-12. Gibault with the serve again. And here it comes. There's the dig by Schmittler. Set up by Merbarger. Kaylee shoots that one. And that's going to be a kill for Kaylee. That's more like it, Kaylee. We've got to see more of that. Now here's Zoe back in as Watkins goes to the bench. 14-12, Edwards County here in set number 2. There's the whistle. Zoe steps forward. Shoots it down the middle of the back row. There's the dig towards the net. Pushed. All right, back to us. Dug out by James. Set up by Zoe. Pushed over by Merbarger. They bump it again to their middle and pushed into the net. We'll take that. Knocked into the net there by Goldschmidt. 15-12, Edwards County here in set 2.
One of her few mistakes in this game.
Yeah, she doesn't make many. All right, there's Markman's serve again to the middle. That ball dives as it goes to the middle. Now they set it up. Blocked down by Alcorn. Beautiful play by Nicole Alcorn. Tell you what, Nicole's the one who's saving us, Troy.
Whoa.
16-12, Edwards County by four here in set two. Markman again with the serve. Here it comes. Again to the middle of court. There's their dig. They push it to that left side again. A shot dug out by Schmidler, but out of bounds. You know, when you think about it, just about all their shots come from their left side.
Oh, yeah.
16-13. They have the serve. Their libero, Madeline O'Neill. There it goes down the middle. That hits the top of the net, but Kaylee digs it out. Markman is shot by Kaylee. It's a kill for Kaylee. 17-13. Kaylee the killer.
And thankfully, Goldschmidt touched it, too,
yeah.
Just for insurance.
Yeah, because it hit the top of the net off the kill shot.
Right.
And then she touched it, and it went out of bounds. 17-13. Alcorn with the serve. Good serve right there at the middle. They dig it up to the net. Out of bounds. Another, that's an ace. An ace for Nicole. 18-13. Come on, Lions. Finish them off. And then get ready to win set three. Nicole looks to the bench, gets the signal. Shoots it down the middle. There's, oh, that's an ace. That goes off the hands of number 14, Kelly Dooley.
She was not ready for it.
I don't think she was, Troy. Edwards County 19, Gibault Catholic 13. Alcorn still has the serve. Here she comes. Good serve in the middle. They dig it towards. That's going to go to the crowd. That's another ace for Nicole.
Two horrible digs by Dooley.
Yeah. 20 and 13. Maybe we've got them scared now, Troy.
Could be, Dave.
Nicole getting ready for another serve. Here it comes. Good serve. There's their dig at the net. Left side shot down the line. It was touched.
Yep.
That would have been out, Troy, but yep. We touched it.
But you can understand them wanting to try and set
up
a block.
Oh, yeah. That has to be a split-second decision as to whether to go after it or not, and you can't really blame them. 20-14 the score. And what's the time here?
New ball for some reason.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. They brought another ball in here. I don't know. Where'd the other one end up?
No clue, sir.
Grohman will serve it now for the Hawks of Gibault Catholic. There it goes down the middle. Dug out by Kaylee. Set up by Zoe. Shoot over by Merbarger. They play that again. Towards the left again. Here it comes. Top of the nice dig by Alcorn. Set up by Zoe. Or a shot now by Kaylee. Kill. Merbarger is the one that set that up instead of Zoe.
That's it.
21-14. Edwards County needs four more points to win it. And there goes Kaylee James back to serve it. Kaylee gets the whistle. Looks to the bench again. Here comes the serve. Right down the middle, there's their dig. Push it again to the middle, shot down the line, dug out by Kaylee. Bumped forward by Alcorn. Kaylee just pumps it back over to him. There's their dig. They set it to the left side. Here's their shot, partially blocked. Nice save by Zoe, bumped up, and that's not going to be enough. Couldn't recover enough to get it back over, so they get the point. Edwards County 21, Gibault Catholic 15. And they still have the serve. Number five, Lauren Goldschmidt, the servant. Here she comes. Shoots it. Back road. Alcorn digs it. Merbarger sets it. Caitlin shoots it over the end line.
No, he says it's in.
Are you kidding me?
No, the referee up there on the chair said it's in.
Okay. Looked out to me, Troy. But we'll take it. 22-15, Edwards County. Merbarger will serve it. Of course, my 65-year-old eyes, all going on 66, I could have missed it. Here's Merbarger with the serve down the middle. There's a nice serve. They push it to the right side, tip over to us. It's a well-placed tip. Megan Watkins, who's in the lineup now, just could not get to it. And that makes it 22-16. So we haven't got it polished off yet.
Good job there by Megan Brands, if that's how you pronounce it.
Probably. Good enough for me.
Yeah, good enough.
There's their serve. Back row dig by Watkins, bumped up by Merbarger, pushed over by Caitlin. They dig it out, push it back to the back. Wait a minute, did I get a lift?
It is two hits.
Two hits. Edwards County 23, Gibault Catholic 16. Come on, Caitlin, finish them off here with two serves. Caitlin Schmidler, the senior middle blocker, shoots it down the middle. There's their block, or their dig and a shot. Let it go, it's out, it's out. Edwards County 24, Gibault Catholic 16. Let's get these Catholic girls rattled, Troy.
I think they are just.
If they are Catholic.
Well, yeah.
Here's Schmidtler's serve. There's their dig. Middle of the net, push to the left side, push back over. Oh, dug out nicely by Mulbarger, and Kaylee can't get it back over. So, Gibault Catholic gets that point. 24-17 with set point now. And back to serve will be Bailey Lehman. Bailey likes to serve from the right side of the end line. Here she comes forward, pushes it down the middle, dig by Kaylee. Set up by Mulbarger and tipped over by Alcorn to the back row. They dig it out. Push it here to the left side. There's the shot. Kaylee digs that out. Mulbarger sets it. Mark shoots it. And that's it. Edwards County wins it. Edwards County comes back to win set number two, 25-17. Troy checks some broadcast boosters.
Larry and Linda Schmittler, grandparents of Caitlin Schmittler, Larry Schmittler Service, Oil Field Engine Repair in Grayville. Stu and Janina Martin, along with Zed and Zimmy Martin, Zoe's family. Getting too excited here.
Yeah.
Tom and Kay Moore, Taylor Roosevelt's grandparents, Rogerita and Kinsey James, Kaylee James' family, Lonnie and Valerie and Hallie Murbarger and Anna, Sadie's family, Daryl and Judy Knight, Nicole Alcorn's grandparents, Kane and Jackie Copeland, Georgia Shirley Tribe, Glenn and Marilyn Clodfelder, Kaylee James' grandparents, Volleyball MC Todd Bailey of TCB Tire Repair, TCB Detail Repair and Tires on the Square in Albion. When you need tires, check with Todd. Bill and Susan Markman, grandparents of Zoe Markman, Carrie Wayne, JT, and Callie Doss, cheering on Nicole Alcorn from Spring, Texas, Kathy and Jim Markman of CJ's Auto Sales and Service and CJ's Rental Homes, former Midwest kid Gary Holtman, now in Grants Pass, Oregon, Earl and Judy Loudermilk, Tim and Alicia Yates, Debbie Smith, new Edwards County Treasurer, and Kai Coleman, Kaylee James' cousin. And I think our cheering section is trying to prove that they can out-yell the Hawks section.
Yeah, I think so. I think they're doing it, too.
Yeah, I think so.
Of course, we got them outnumbered.
Well, this is
probably 2-1.
Yeah, it's a little bit Alamo-ish, but you know.
Yeah. Well, Troy, we lost that first set and did not play very good volleyball. 25-19.
No.
Played still not. I still don't think we have seen the Lady Lions here today at their best, but they did play good enough to win the second set. 25-17.
And by the same token, regardless of where these girls come from, that's a good volleyball team they're playing
on. Oh, yeah.
They're going to have to play hard to earn this victory, but they can do it.
Yeah. Well, I think I've mentioned this before on our broadcast, but there is a proposal before the IHSA to separate all the private schools out when it comes to state tournament time, that all the private schools would have to play in a separate classification. And if that were so, Gibault Catholic would not be here. They and the team that beat us last year in the state finals, Immaculate Conception Catholic, and last year, as I've mentioned, well, there goes Stu Markman. Get him on the camera there. There goes Stu running back and forth, urging the fans to. Good job, Stu, getting all the Edwards County fans to do the wave. And the Edwards County girls now are going to be on the other side of the court. What I started to say, well, he's going over there to the other side, getting all of our fans that are seated over there in the end zone area. Well, Stu's doing a great job. I hope he don't run out of breath there and collapse on us.
Don't do that.
No. But anyway, what I started to say is there's a proposal before the IHSA to separate all of the private schools out. And you stop and think about it, folks. They are not limited within a school boundary line. They can get players from anywhere. In fact, I heard somebody say that the day school team that won Class 1A for the last 2 years, the big tall girl, their best hitter, doesn't start playing with them until sectional time. Well, that's not fair, Troy. That's not fair. Private or public schools have to stay and make sure and prove that the girls or boys on their teams, their parents, reside within the boundary lines of the school district. Enough of that. Here we go. Sadie Marks will serve it for Edwards County. There's the serve to the middle of the court. There's the dig. They push it to their left side. There's the shot. Dug out by Schmittler. Set up by Mulbarger. Here's Kaylee with a shot. That's a kill for Kaylee.
Not yet.
Oh, can they get it back? Yes, they do. Kaylee digs it out. I'm sorry. A little premature there. Nicole, but that one's blocked out of bounds. Nicole Alcorn gets that one for Edwards County. Well, you got to say, Jabot did a good job digging that one out after Kaylee shot it hard.
Good play by both sides.
But Nicole and Naylor got it down. 1-0 Edwards County. Marks with the serve. Here it goes. There's down the right side. Dug towards the net. Bumped up high. Left side shot. Dig by Schmittler. Set up by Merbarger. Kaylee tips it over, and they can't get it over. There, that was one time when the tip worked. Edwards County 2, Gibault Catholic nothing. We win this set, folks. We're going to normal next weekend.
And on a lighter note, Zoe was getting a kick out of her dad.
Yeah. What was he doing?
There's the aisle.
Oh, Zoe, I'm sorry. And they knock it into the net but push it back. And there's a dig by Schmittler. Set up by Merbarger. Kaylee just tips it over, but they keep it alive. Good play on their side. Shot. And Caitlin digs that out. Set up by Merbarger. Here's a tip over by Zoe, but they play that over. And to the left side, here's the tip over. Dug out by Kaylee. Merbarger sets it up, and she's going to be called for a lift.
Yeah, a lift.
You know, Troy, during the warm-ups, I noticed that Sadie Merbarger was practicing sets behind her instead of in front of her. All right, it's Edwards County 2, Gibault 1, and they have the serve. Here it comes. There's the dig back there by Schmittler. Bumped up by Zoe. Pushed over by Merbarger. It's on their side now. They push it to the left side. Here's a shot into the net. Knocked into the net there by number 14, Kelly Dooley. Edwards County up 3-1 here in set number 3.
We need to somehow get her and Goldschmidt off their game.
Yeah, yeah. All right. Markman with the serve again. Here it comes. There's this dig. Push to the left side. Oh, they bump it back to us. Kaylee digs it. Zoe sets it. Alcorn shoots it. Was it touched? It was in. Doesn't make a difference whether it was touched or not. The line judge says it was in. Edwards County 4, Gibault Catholic 1. Good start here in this deciding set, Troy. Markman will serve it again for Edwards County. Zoe, the sophomore, she'll be back next year, but she wants to win this year. Zoe dribbling that volleyball, steps forward, shoots it down the middle. There's the dig from the middle of the court. Push to the net. Shot.
Oh.
Is out. Yes. And I think we didn't get a timeout. No, maybe not a timeout. I thought maybe they were going to call timeout. Edwards County 5, Gibault Catholic 1. Markman again with the serve. There it goes, down the right side this time. There's the dig towards the net, pushed over to us, dug out by Kaylee, set up by Zoe. Kaylee shoots it, and she got it in! Better take a drink of water. Timeout, Gibault! Edwards County 6, Gibault 1. Troy.
You could sense there was a timeout coming. David and Glenna Summers, Pam Mann, Nina Mann, and Terry Mavis, Robert and Damona Neese, Bob and Linda Caldwell, Marla Caldwell Alexander cheering on cousins Nicole and Zoe from Anacortes, Washington. Brad and Tammy Nail. Eddie and Joyce Miller. Kent and Sue Nail of Nail's Funeral Homes in Albany, Fairfield. Gospel Chapel and Non-Denominational Church in Bonegap. Services begin every Sunday morning at 10. Janice Shaw of Janice's Beauty Shop in Albany. She offers a complete line of beauty shop services for women, and she also cuts hair for men. Call Janice for an appointment, 445-2436. Radio station WVYN 90.9 in Wayne City, The Vine, featuring the best Christian music in Southern Illinois. Do you need your carpets cleaned? Call Dan Aaron of Dan's Carpet Cleaning, 618-302-0972. Dan, Shirley, Michael, and Travis are cheering on the Lions.
Well, that was Dylan Root over there leading the cheering section, which is located behind what I would call the end zone.
Yeah.
All right, Edwards County 6, Gibault Catholic 1. Zoe Markman still has the serve for Edwards County. Here we go. Come on, Zoe. Keep it going. Keep it going. Zoe steps forward. Shoots it down the middle. There's their dig from the middle of the court. At the net. Pushed into the net. They tried to catch us off guard, and they shot themselves in the foot as Amanda Groman pushed it into the net. Edwards County 7, Gibault Catholic 1. Once again, Markman will have the serve. Here it comes. It's a good serve. There's the dig from the middle. Pushed back to the back row. Shot. Oh, that's going to go off the hands of Sadie Marks out of bounds. That'll be a kill there. Or did you see who shot it?
That was Goldschmidt.
Goldschmidt again. All right. 7-2. Edwards County by 5. Serve coming from Dooley. There it goes. There's the dig back there by Schmittler. Zoe sets it up. Kaylee fires it in there. Oh, they had no chance on that one, Troy. Kaylee the killer smacks it.
That was the exact look that Dooley had on her face. She was saying, nothing I can do with that.
8-2 the score. Now Alcorn will serve it for Edwards County. Good serve. In the middle, there's the dig at the net. And can't get it over. That'll be an ace for Nicole. Edwards County 9, Gibault Catholic 2. Edwards County fans loving every minute of this. Didn't like the first set, but they're liking this. Here's Alcorn's serve. And it's an ace! They let it go down the left side, and it fell in. According to the line judge, Edwards County 10, Gibault Catholic 2. Come on, girls, don't let up. Don't take your foot off the gas pedal here. Alcorn with the serve. Good serve to the back row. It's in! They let that one bounce.
Both the libero and Lehman, they just watched. Edward, did nothing about it.
Yeah, Edwards County 11. Maybe we've got them shocked, Troy.
Babe, I think you've got, this is the thing about the middle part of the game. I think they've got the Hawks now.
All right, there's the serve by Alcorn. There's the dig from the middle. Push to the left side. There's a shot, partially blocked, but it goes out of bounds off the block by Schmittler. And so that makes it 11-3 now. And the Hawks from Waterloo, the Catholic high school called Gibault. It'll be O'Neill serving for our opponent. There's the serve. Back row dig by Alcorn at the net. Tipped over by Zoe, but I think they're going to call it for a lift.
Yep. That's it.
Nice try by Zoe, because that ball was headed for the net.
Yeah.
That's about all she could do with it.
Right.
11-4. Edwards County by 7. Here comes the serve. Into the net, but it goes on over. Hit the top of the net, and then fell on our side. Folks, that is tough to defend when that ball on a serve hits the top of the net, because you never know exactly where it's going to end up. 11-5 now. Once again, O'Neill with the serve. There's the dig back there by Alcorn. Zoe pushes it over to him. At the middle of the net, they set it to the left. Here's a shot, partially blocked, saved out by Zoe, but it's going to fall to the floor. So now Gibault's beginning to make a comeback. Edwards County 11, Gibault 6. Again, O'Neill with the serve for the Hawks. And she comes forward now, shoots it down the middle. There's the dig by James, set up by Zoe. Kaylee just tips it over and gets the point. That time Kaylee knew exactly where she wanted to tip the ball.
Everybody was coming expecting her to slam it down to the right. Went with the tip instead.
Edwards County 12, Gibault 6. Kaylee James with the serve. Good serve. There's their dig in the middle of the court. Push it to the left side. Here's their shot. Partially blocked. Boy, Troy, we're just not making good blocks at the net. And that makes it 12-7. Off of our blocks, the ball is going out of control. And that could be because of the way it's being shot by the opponent. 12-7 the score. Here comes their serve. Back row dig by James. Merbarger sets it up. Caitlin shoots it down. Caitlin the wool. Caitlin the crammer. 13-7 Edwards County. Set three. Now here's Markman to the bench as Watkins checks in, and Sadie Merbarger goes back to serve. Merbarger from the left side of the end line. The left-hander slaps it down the middle. There's their dig. Ball high in the air. Push to the left side. Shot is in. Good kill shot for the Hawks.
Goldschmidt.
Goldschmidt again. 13-8. Hawks hanging right around here as Edwards County has a five-point advantage here in set three. The deciding set, by the way. They have the serve, and here it comes. There's the dig by Alcorn. Set up by Merbarger. Tip over by Caitlin. They keep it alive. Left side shot is good.
That time it was Dooley.
13-9 the score. You know, we've got to figure out some way to keep that ball from going to their left side. Because that's where they shoot them all.
That's where they do it.
13-9. Edwards County still leading, but now by only four. Here's their serve. Dig by Alcorn. Bumped up by Marks. Pushed over by Kaylee. They dig it out. They set it to the right side this time and shoot it. Dig out by Alcorn. Set up by Merbarger. Caitlin shoots it over. They dig that out. Push it to their left side. Here we go again. And that's in again for another kill.
Dave, we're not doing a very good job of defending that left corner.
No, we're not.
Not only are they getting kill shots there, but they're doing easy taps into that corner.
13-10. Somebody's going to sleep on covering and defending that corner of the court. All right, here's the serve. Back row dig by Alcorn. Set up by Watkins, and now she's going to be called for a lift. For two hits.
Two hits. Which you may, I would have bought a lift more than I would have two hits.
Yeah, 13-11 now. Edwards County leading by only two now here in the deciding set. Gibault has the serve. There it goes. There's the dig by Kaylee. Merbarger sets it up. Watkins shoots it and scores. Megan Watkins from the left side. Megan's going to be back next year. So that's encouraging.
Yep.
Because we're going to lose a lot of our frontline players after this year.
Yep.
14-11, Edwards County. Caitlin Schmidtler with a serve. There it goes down the middle. There's their dig. They push it again to their left side. Here comes another shot. This time Kaylee's there to dig it out. Merbarger. Mark shoots it. And they dig it back to us. Tip over by Watkins, but they keep it alive. Back to their middle. Shot is good. That time they shot from the middle and caught us off guard.
Pappenberg knocked that one in for them.
Edwards County 14, Gibault Catholic 12, in a very close seesaw match here. Edwards County had built up a good point lead, but now that's kind of beginning to evaporate. Here's their serve. James with a dig. Merbarger sets it. Alcorn shoots it and kills it. Boy, Nicole Alcorn is really playing well today, Troy.
Yes, sir.
We're not keeping stats today, so we'll not be able to tell you the end results here. Troy's running the camera for us. 15-12, Edwards County. And Sadie Marks will go back to serve it. Marks gets the whistle. Sadie dribbles the ball a couple of times, shoots it down the middle to the back row. There's their dig. Edwards County fans wanted a lift. Dug out by Schmidtler, and the ball at the net. Shot to the back row. Schmidtler dug it out. James pushed back over by Alcorn. Should have let that one go. That would have been out. Left side shot. Dug out by James. Set up Schmidtler. Kaylee shoots it. They dig it back to us. Kaylee shoots it again and scores. Kaylee James shoots it down. Edwards County 16. Dakota Catholic 12. That brought the Edwards County fans to their feet.
I would say so.
Marks with a serve again. Nice play by the senior outside hitter, Kaylee James. There's the serve to the back row. The dig at the net. Tipped down by Kaylee. Edwards County gets the point. 17-12, Edwards County. Set three. Marks with the serve. Come on, girls. Put them away. Put them away. Here's Marks' serve. Good serve. There's their dig. Right side to the left. And pushed back to us. Kaylee digs it. Merbarger sets it. Alcorn shoots it, but blocked back to us. Pushed back over there by James. It's on their side now, and they let it fall. They let it fall. Edwards County 18, Gibault 12, and they want to tie it again, okay? You don't know where you were, do you?
You expect me to know after a game like this? Oh, okay. Radio station WBYN 90.9 in Wayne City, The Vine, featuring the best Christian music in Southern Illinois. Do you need your carpets cleaned? Call Dan Aaron of Dan's Carpet Cleaning, 618-302-0972. Dan, Shirley, Michael, and Travis are cheering on the Lions. Sam and Sheila Smith, Ed and Mary Bailey, The Watering Can at 107 West Main Street. Stop in and see the flowers and gift items Nathan has available. Call 445-3924. Chris and Teresa Kelsey, Steve Thompson, your country financial agent in West Salem, Doug Horton, your country financial agent in Albion, Cheryl Taylor and Mary Erickson of T.J. Marsh backing the Lady Lions, T.J. Marsh, over 30 years of serving and supporting the community, and Edwards County Superintendent of Schools, David Cowger.
All right, here we go, back to play. Edwards County still has the serve, leading 18-12 here in the deciding set number three. Sadie Marks will serve it. Sadie gets the whistle. Couple of dribbles of the volleyball. Here she goes. Good serve. To the back row, there's their dig. To the left, bump back to the middle. Shot in is in. Good play shot. Oh, wait a minute. Did he call that out?
He did call it out.
Okay. Well, it was close, but they didn't get the call. 19-12, Edwards County. All right. Marks again with the serve. Here it comes. Back row dig. Ah, that's going to be a lift. That's going to be a lift off of Kelly Dooley. Edwards County 20. Gibault Catholic 12. Five more points, Troy, and we're going to the state.
Five more points.
Sadie Marks will serve it for Edwards County. Here it comes. There's their dig. Left side to the right. Shot down the middle. Oh, Caitlin let it go, but she didn't. And it goes out of bounds. That'll be a point for Gibault Catholic. 20-13 now. Edwards County still leading by seven here in the deciding set number three. Back to serve for the Hawks, Bailey Lehman. Lehman runs forward, shoots it down the middle. Dig by Schmidtler. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Kaylee. Blocked back to us. Nice kill block shot on the Gibault side of the net, I think, by number nine. And I don't know who it is. Maybe it's Rachel Lindauer. We don't have a nine on our score sheet here. 20-14. Gibault still has the serve. There it goes. And dug out by Schmidtler. Merbarger sets it up. Tip over by Nicole. Well, they played that easy. Left side shot, partially blocked, dug out by Merbarger, set up by Watkins. Nicole shoots it, and it's out. That time Nicole tried for the near sideline and missed it. So it's 20-15. Well, we haven't got this one yet, Troy.
Nope.
Bailey Lehman will serve it. Here it comes. There's the dig by Marks. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Kaylee's too long. Oh, come on, girls. 20-16. Lehman will serve it for Gibault. There it goes. Dig by Watkins. Set up by Merbarger. Alcorn shoots it. It's blocked, but we're in the net. We're in the net. 20-17. Lehman will serve it again for the Hawks out of Waterloo, Illinois. There's the serve to the back row. Dig by Marks. Set up by Merbarger. Alcorn tips it over to the back row. They dig it. Push it to the left. Here comes a shot. Partially blocked. James digs it. Set up by Merbarger. Kaylee shoots it. And they hit it two, three times. That's going to be it. 21-17. Nice shot by Kaylee James that they could not control. Here's Zoe Markman in for Watkins again to go back and serve it. Lions need four more points. Four more points. Zoe waiting for the whistle. There it is. Here it comes. Good serve. There's the dig. Ball high in the air, middle of the court. Pushed back to the back row. Shot. Dug out by James. Set up by Zoe. Shot by Kaylee. Dug out. Right side pushed to the left. Here comes their tip over. And well-placed tip. Nobody there. 21-18. Back to serve. Kelly Dooley. Kelly Dooley, a 5'8 freshman. She gets the whistle. Here comes her serve. Nice dig by Merbarger. Set up by Zoe. Kaylee shoots it. Good! They let it go! They let it go, and it falls within the end line. 22-18. Three more points now, folks. Three more points, and it's another trip to normal for the state finals next weekend. Alcorn serving. There it goes. Back row dig. Right side. Push to the left again. Shot. Good. Shooting at that time, Lauren Goldschmidt. 22-19. Back to serve for them, Madeline O'Neill. Their libero. And here it comes. Back row dig by Alcorn. Zoe sets it up. Kaylee shoots it. Partially blocked. They dug it out. Push it back to us. Alcorn digs it. Zoe sets it. Pushed over by Caitlin. It's on their side now. Back to the left side. Here they go again. And it's out. Yeah, that time they shot it out, trying to go down the far sideline. 23-19. Lions need two more points now. Kaylee James to serve it. Come on, Kaylee. Good serve. There's their dig at the middle of the court. Push to the left again. Here she goes. Partially blocked, and that's going to be another kill. We just don't seem to have an answer for those shots on the left side, Troy.
Especially when it's Goldschmidt over there.
23-20. Haven't got it won yet, folks. Back to serve is Ashley Groman. Groman gets the whistle. Comes forward now. Shoots it to the middle. There's the dig by Markman, set up by James. Shot by Schmettler. They dig that out. Push it again to the left side. Here we go again. Dug by James. Set up by Zoe. Marks now shoots it. They dig that out pretty easily. Back to the left side. Here we go again. Dig by Kaylee. Set up by Zoe. Marks shoots it over. They played that easily. Push it back to the left side. Tip over to us. Well-placed tip. They just won't go away, Troy.
Do they look like a bunch of freshmen and sophomores?
No, they don't.
No, they don't.
No, they don't. 23-21. Edwards County's lead now is two. There's another serve for Gibault Catholic. And at the top of the net, dug out by Merbarger, knocked over by Kaylee to save it. Now they have it to the left. A shot. Dug out by Alcorn, but that's going to go in the crowd. 23-22. Boy, Troy, if we lose this, it's going to be a... Is Casey going to call timeout? No.
No, she is not.
23-22. Edwards County still by a point. Groman with the serve. There it goes. Back row dig off of Alcorn for an ace. And now we're tied. I can't believe it. I cannot believe it. Finally, we get a timeout. Troy?
Sadie Marks family, Kent, Jamie Lynn Clay, and Ellie Marks, David and Lisa Mathis, Doug and Linda Raber, Doug is your state farm insurance agent in Albion, Gene Kolak, owner of the Man Cave Gallery in Fairfield, Western memorabilia, motivational posters, pictures, and Native American art. Gene carries many custom handmade and factory knives. Shad, Marilee Lindsay, and Seth McKenzie of McKenzie Farms, Dr. Chris Ballard and his wife Jerry, Kevin and Heidi and TJ Smurden, Keith, Kayla Avery, and Drew Roosevelt, family of senior band member and volleyball player Taylor Roosevelt, David and Amy Brewster, Brewster Enterprises, Incorporated, supporting Kate Brewster, Russ Seeley Max, and Clive Gerlach, and Linda Sachs.
As we go back to play, tied in the deciding third set at 23, the lineup has James, Alcorn, and Markman on the back row, Merbarger, Schmittler, and Marks on the front row. Now Kaylee James, our captain, calls the girls together for a huddle at the top of the circle in the basketball court, and now they fan out. The serve belongs to Ashley Grillman for Gibault Catholic. Here it comes. Dig by Markman, set up by Schmittler, shot by Marks. They dig it out, push it to the left side. Here we go again, partially blocked, dug out by Alcorn, set up by Merbarger, shot by Marks. They dig that out. Edwards County wanted a lift call but didn't get it. And now they lock it in the net. Edwards County 24. Waterloo 23. One more point and we win, Troy. One more point. One more stinking point. All right. Merbarger will serve it for Edwards County. Sadie, the senior. Sadie, Edwards County fans on their feet now. Here comes Sadie's serve. It's a good one to the middle of the court. There's the dig. Ball at the net. Bump to the left. Shot. Dig by Kaylee. And Mark saves it, but nobody can save it after that. And that ties the score again at 24.
Oof. Which means there will be some overtime.
Yeah. Lauren Goldschmidt. 25 is a normal winning score, but you got to win by two. And we're both at 24 right now. Gibault with the serve. Here it comes. There's the dig by James. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Caitlin's a kill. Caitlin Schmittler gets a kill from the right side that time. And Edwards County goes up 25-24. Now Caitlin will go back to serve it for Edwards County. And here it comes. Kind of a rainbow serve. Dug from the back line. Set to their left again. Here we go. There's the shot. They got a kill again. Tied at 25. Man, oh man, that girl from the left side is killing us.
She's an outstanding player, Dave. Got to give credit where it's due.
All right, back to serve is Carolyn Pappenberg. We're tied at 25 now. Here comes the serve. There's the dig by Marks. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Nicole as it goes in the net. And now they get the point. Four hits against Edwards County. Megan Watkins is in the lineup right now for Zoe Markman. 26-25. They get a point now and they win. Well, hold on, folks. Here comes the serve. There's the dig by James. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Alcorn. Blocked back over. Alcorn digs it out. And Kaylee just tips it back over to him. Now here comes left side. Here we go. And that's out. All right. That's out. And that ties the score again at 26. And Sadie Marks will go back to serve it for Edwards County. Boy, I don't know if I can drive home after this, Troy. Marks with a serve. Good one down the right side. There's their dig. Middle of the court set up. Pushed back to us, and that is in. Oh! Oh! 27-26. Gibault with the lead. Bailey Lehman will go back to serve it. And they need just one more point to put us away and end our season. Here comes the serve. Here's the dig by Marks. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Kaylee. Yes. Can they save it back? Yeah, they do. Dig by Schmittler. Set up by Merbarger. Shot by Kaylee. It's good for a kill. And so we're tied again at 27. Back and forth we go. Boy, what a match. What a match. Watkins comes out as Zoe Markman comes in to serve it. 27-27. Markman gets the whistle. Here comes the serve. There's the dig from the back row. Pushed to the back and a shot. Dug by Kaylee. Pushed forward by Caitlin, shot over by Kaylee. They push it. Here come the goal. Left side, shot, dug out by Kaylee. Set up by Zoe, shot by Alcorn, dug out. Pushed back to us, dig out by Zoe, set up Merbarger, shot by Kaylee's goal! Kaylee James with a kill! Edwards County on top now, 28-27.
Dave, beyond any shadow of a doubt, no matter what the final score of this game is, this is the best volleyball game we've ever broadcast.
Yeah, I think you're right. All right, here's Zoe's serve. Come on, Zoe. Good serve. There's the dig at the net. Push to the left. Here's their shot. Dug out by Schmettler. Set up by Zoe. Here's Kaylee. Edwards County wins it! Edwards County wins it! 29-27. The Lions are going back to normal Illinois for the third year in a row. Edwards County wins it! Yeah!
Here we come, Redbird Arena.
Yeah. Oh, man, what a match it was. 29-27. Again, you got to give these Gibault Catholic girls a lot of credit, Troy. They would not go away. They just would not go away. And it took a supreme effort by Edwards County to win this match and earn the right to go to the state finals.
Well, Dave, as we said at the beginning of that broadcast, you don't get here by a fluke.
No.
They did not play like a bunch of freshmen and sophomore girls. You know, they're going to have a very good future with that team.
Oh, yeah.
When you got players that young that are that good. But you also knew, too, Dave, how much heart these Edwards County Lady Lions have. When they play to the best of their ability, they'll figure out a way to come out on top.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Wow. I'll tell you what. I hope, folks, you don't take offense when I sound negative, but that's when I know that we can do better. And for some reason, don't. But, boy, you got to give them credit. They pulled it out when sometimes it didn't look like it was going to happen. Troy, check some broadcast boosters, and then we'll put a cap on this.
There we go.
There we go.
Russ Seeley, Max and Clive Gerlach, Linda Sachs, Jeff Gillard of Gillard True Value Hardware in Albion and Grayville, Connie and Ray, grandparents of Maddie Gillard, Myrna Mason, Randy and Jared Hallam of Mitchell Insurance Agency in Albion, Steve and Beverly Ward, Donna Marilyn Brewster, Jason Holfaker, Linda Oxby, former Edwards County girls volleyball coach, Emma Campbell Smith, Betty and Kenny Smith, Zoe Markman's great grandparents, Eddie and Lila Fuchs, Victor and Farrellyn Oxby, Linda Oxby's parents, Phil and Nancy Watkins in Grants Pass, Oregon, Megan's grandparents, Ronald and Marilyn Mann, Don and Deanna James, Kaylee James' grandparents, Larry and Linda Schmittler, grandparents of Caitlin Schmittler, Larry Schmittler Service, Oilfield Engine Repair in Grayville, Stu, Shanina Zed, and Zimmy Markman, Zoe's family, Tom and Kay Moore, Taylor Roosevelt's grandparents, Roger Rita and Kinsey James, Kaylee James' family, and Lonnie, Valerie, and Hallie Merbarger, and Anna, Sadie's family, and we want to thank the Merbargers for all of their help with the camera work this season.
Yes. Valerie sent me an email, wanted to know if I'd let her off of the camera duties for today's match. She said, I'd sure like to be able to watch Sadie play. And I said, well, sure, I understand. You know, you weren't nailed to that job. And so we really do appreciate all the work that Valerie and Hallie have done this year in running the camera for us. But Troy can do the job. We just don't have stats at the end to tell you about. But, you know, it's not really
official stats anyway.
Yeah, they're not official stats anyway. No. So anyway, well, here's the way things stand now, folks. Edwards County will be playing at 12 noon Friday afternoon at Redbird Arena in Normal, Illinois. Troy and I will be there, but we will not be able to do video. The IHSA will not allow us to do video broadcasting, so our broadcast Friday and Saturday, because you know we're going to play two games up there. We're going to play, first of all, if we win, we're playing for the championship Saturday. If we lose that match on Friday, then we play for third place.
Right.
Well, either way, all we can do is audio broadcasting like we did last year. No big problem.
Right.
Now, if you folks insist that you want to watch it on your computer, you're going to have to pay the IHSA a fee to do it. Well, that's up to you to decide whether it's worth it.
Yeah.
Or whether you'd rather hear our description of it. Either way, we could use more broadcast boosters because now we're going to have to pay a $100 fee to the IHSA to be able to broadcast up there.
Right.
Plus, we're going to have to secure hotel or motel reservations. That'll cost us another $80 or $90.
Probably.
And then on the gasoline to go up there. So, folks, if you'd like to help us with our expenses and bringing you exciting Lady Lions volleyball action, My mailing address is Dave Rigg, 1302 County Road 345 East, Albion, Illinois, 62806. I'll appreciate any donations you folks would like to be able to make. If you'd like to become a broadcast booster and be on our broadcast, because if, as Stu Markman was saying earlier, he said, man, this is good advertising, and it's a whole lot cheaper than the newspaper or radio advertising. Yeah. And now, you know, we've only been charging them $1 for every broadcast that we do. So if you'd like to become a broadcast booster, which is good public relations or good advertising for any business you might have, send me an email. My email address is gospeltime@earthlink.net. Again, that's gospeltime, G-O-S-P-E-L-T-I-M-E, @earthlink.net. Or you can send me a message through Facebook. On there on Facebook, you can find my Facebook page and send me a message and let us know your name, what you'd like for Troy to stumble through whenever he reads the broadcast boosters, and your mailing address, too, if you would. And we'll get you on our broadcast this coming Friday afternoon from Normal, Illinois, on the campus of Illinois State. Is that right? Illinois State?
Illinois State University.
Illinois State University.
The Redbirds.
And who are we going to be playing? Well, we don't know. It's either going to be Deer Creek Mackinac or Moroa Forsyth. Whoever wins that super-sectional match tonight, which starts at 7 o'clock at Moroa, will be our opponent. Again, that's Friday at 12 noon. And our broadcast here on Edwards County Sportsnet would begin at, let's say, 11:45 Friday morning. Anything else need to be said, Troy?
Dave, I think this game, hopefully, one way you could look at it, because if you thought this was tough, Dave, we've been up to Redbird Arena now 2 years in a row. You know, out of those other teams that are left, whether it's Deermack, that Elmhurst school, whatever, if you thought this was a nail-biter, it's going to get even more intense up there.
Yeah.
So, in a way, Dave, I would have loved it if they would have been able to just smash them down the way they did Tri-County and Newton in the second set. Didn't happen that way, but they fought hard, they won, and hopefully they can take the momentum of this hard-fought victory over a very good team filled with freshmen and sophomores up there to Redbird Arena next week, and maybe this time we went from third place to second place this year. How about a championship?
Yeah, I agree. You know, one other thing I want to say before we close out this broadcast, and I don't mean this as a slam in any way of Casey Nelson or her assistants, Terry and Erica, but a lot of the credit for this team also should go to Linda Oxby.
Well, sure.
I mean, Linda trained these girls.
Right.
And Casey inherited a good volleyball team, but she's done a good job keeping the tradition going and keeping things going. Casey's made a few changes from what Linda used to do, but she's kept the basic concept out there. And so, again, Linda Oxby, I know most likely she's watching this broadcast. And, Linda, I know you feel just as proud of these girls as anybody else does, and rightly so.
And rightly so.
And I also want to give credit to the volleyball coaches at the grade school level.
Absolutely.
Chad McKenzie is the head volleyball coach for the Albion grade school. I'm not sure who the head volleyball coach is at West Salem.
Me neither.
But those grade school coaches have done a great job preparing those grade school kids for competition on the high school level when they get up here. Because, again, you know, I was asked on that the sports couch on WVYN this morning, and I mentioned to him, you know, our JV team won 14 matches and lost only one, and our freshman team won 7 matches and lost only 2. So, yeah, we got some big shoes to fill next year, but the talent is there at the bottom levels to fill in those shoes. But anyway, we don't worry about that now. We got the tournament coming up next week. So, again, Edwards County wins here tonight. Or today, I should say, in 3 sets, losing that first set, not really playing traditional Edwards County-style volleyball, losing to Waterloo Gibault Catholic Hawks 25-19, but then coming back to win set number 2, 25-17, and then in a thriller in what you have to call overtime, Edwards County edges Waterloo Gibault Catholic 29-27. And for the third year in a row, the Edwards County Lady Lions are going to the state finals, hoping to win the state championship. Maybe the third time is the charm, Troy. We finished fourth the first time we were up there, second last year. Let's take the state championship in Class 2A this year.
And you know, there were some naysayers out there who said they couldn't get this far again. Well, yeah. They're going again, folks.
Yep.
Third year in a row.
Yep. Yep. Well, I think that's all that needs to be said here. As you can see there on your screen there, a lot of the Edwards County fans have poured out onto the court now to take pictures with their cell phone cameras of the girls and congratulate them. So it's a happy trip now back to Edwards County, about a two-hour drive.
Yep.
So if my wife is watching and listening, folks, we're fine. It'll take us a little while to pack up all this equipment and get out of this gymnasium back out to the car. But we should be home. What time is it now? Well, not quite 2:30. We should be home by 5:30 at the latest. I won't go into that. Anything else needs to be said?
I think we got it all, Dave. A tough game. They pulled it out. They won. And this was just another thing here, Dave, of what we had mentioned the other day. I think Kaylee, Caitlin, Sadie Merbarger, and even there for Delaney and Taylor, your five seniors, they wanted to be able to say that they got back to Redbird Arena again, and they're going to do it.
Yeah. You know, and the great thing about this internet broadcasting, Troy, people all over the world can watch these live broadcasts, and because they are not only presented live on our internet website, but they're recorded and stored there and kept there for a long time. So even these girls, when they get home tonight, if they want to watch how they played, they can go back and watch it on the website. For you folks who wonder about cell phones, most cell phones can also pick up these broadcasts. It's just when you get to our website, you want to click on that mobile view, and that should bring it up.
Yep.
On most cell phones. Okay. Well, again, the final scores. Edwards County loses the first set, 25-19, but comes back in thrilling fashion, winning the second set, 25-17, and in overtime, knocks off Waterloo Gibault Catholic, 29-27, and the Lady Lions are going back to the state finals. So until we greet you again Friday morning at about 11:45 from Redbird Arena in Normal, Illinois, on behalf of our broadcast boosters and my partner Troy, this is Dave Rigg bidding you a pleasant good afternoon from Vandalia, Illinois.